Chandraya, Radhikaya Tadaya, Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya, Tad Bhaktaya Namonu, Anandalila Maya Vigrahaya, Prima Bhadivyatcha Visundaraya, Tasmai Mahaprema Rasapradaya, Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste, Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste, Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste. First of all, I have for my Sastang Dhanavat Puspanjali, my heart like flowers thousands of times at the lotus feet of my holy master, Asmadir Paramaradhatam Guru Pada Padma, Nitilila Pravisht Om Vishnupada Stodra Satsishima Drupanuga Charivaya Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj. Secondly, I offer my pranam to my Param Gurudev, to Srila Prabhupada and all of our Sri Rupanuga Gaudiya Guru Parampara. And finally, I offer my pranam to all the Vaishnavas headed by Pujapada Sri Bhaktivedanta Tirthankara Maharaj, Rastanas Prukhas Chandru and all Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis Vanchakavra Turma Sakhimasa. Ishwarera Janma Titi Jehino Pavitra Seimata Vaishnavera Titira Charitra. Srila Vrindavadas Thakur, he said that just as the birthday of Krishna, Janmastami, is Pavitra, completely pure, transcendental, divine event. So similarly, the glories of the appearance days of the pure Vaishnavas are not less important. Same atam, in the same way, Vaishnavera Titira Charitra, in the same way are the Charitra, the glories of the appearance days of great Vaishnavas. It is said, na karma bandhana janma vaishnavanam na vidyate. Vaishnavas have no karma, they have no birth, they have no death. Only by their causes mercy, they are sometimes appearing before our eyes, they become prakat to our senses, and sometimes they become aprakat. They are not visible to our eyes. So, but they are always there. So Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur is not a historical person who is passed away. He is eternally residing in this dham, Navadvip dham, with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and all of his associates with Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Only there is some veil of ignorance separating us from them. How do we come in contact with them? By hearing. Once my Gurudev, he was overhearing a conversation of some disciples of Prabhupada, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, on a philosophical point. And none of them actually had the right, correct understanding. So then he humbly interjected and said, actually, Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur presented in this way. And said, what do you know? You never met him. And then Gurudev said, I have not seen him through the eyes. He said, I have seen him more than you. I did not see him with my eyes, I saw him through my ears by listening to my Gurudev. Then they became angry. What is this person saying? He never met and he's telling us. And they went and they complained to Srila Bhakti Pragyan Kesham Goswami. Srila Bhakti Pragyan Kesham Maharaj, he asked, what was the discussion? And he heard it. And then he said, he was right. He was correct. So what he said is true. He has met with Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur through the hearing process. Now this is extremely important point. In fact, it is the foundational point of all the teachings of Prabhupada Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur. Today is his Vyasa Puja. That means that on this day, the spiritual master is worshipped as a representative of Vyasadeva. That the message of Vyasadeva is coming through. That he is the embodiment of the Guru Tattva. Guru Tattva means original Akanda Guru Tattva is Nityananda Prabhu. When Mahaprabhu was in Puri, he sent Nityananda Prabhu, go to Bengal and preach there. So there's Srila Krishna Skaraj Goswami part. He says, Bhashanda Dalana Ar Prema Pracharan Dui Kare Avadhuta Karena Brahman. Means, when the Avadhut Nityananda Prabhu went to return to Bengal, his Avadhut, that means, Avadhut means his behavior is unconventional, sometimes like a mad person. And when he went to Bengal, what was he doing? Two things. Pashanda Dalan, that means chastising, crushing, correcting the Pashanda, offenders, heretics, atheistic persons, those who were against pure bhakti. And also he was doing prema pracharan and he was preaching prema. So, what is avadut? There are different meanings. If a person is just mad, this is completely mundane. And if a person is acting in an unconventional way just to attract attention to themselves, to be exceptional, this is also completely mundane. Avadhut means whose heart is avadhut, completely cleansed. There is no touch at all in the consciousness of any guna, not even sattva-guna. What to speak of tamas, raja, not even sattva-guna is there. That means the heart is completely overflooded with the titi bhavana vatma yas chamakara bhavu, a flood of vishuddha sattva, which causes the experience of bhakti rasa. That person is actually avadhut. They are really avadut, completely cleansed. Evam brata swapriya nama kirtya jathanura gauduta chitu uchchai hasastiti rotiti roti gayatun madhavam nirtiti lokabhaya. They have a vow to chant fixed number of nam every day. Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Sutako was here. From 1905 to 1915, he made a vow to chant a billion names of Krishna. That means the 192 rounds of Hare Krishna Mahamantra daily. He was chanting there. And one who does this, then what happens? Chatana rago druta chitta utschai. Their chitta completely melts. And sometimes they laugh, sometimes they dance, sometimes they sing, sometimes they cry, sometimes they roll on the ground. And they have no care for what anyone in this external world thinks, anyone's opinion at all. So understand, Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Sutako is in that position. He's avadut. But because he's empowered fully by the Guru Tattva, he has the two missions of Nityananda Prabhu. Pasanda Dalana Ava Prema Pracharan. To smash all the heretical opinions, atheism and impersonalism. And on the other hand, to give prema to everybody. So though he's avadut, though he's beyond all rules, beyond all restrictions, beyond all social conventions, out of kindness for us, then what did he do? Paramahamsa varam paramaptapatim patito darane kritavesha yatim. Out of mercy to deliver all the conditioned souls, he accepted the order of sannyas and established Gaudiya Math. Math means Matanti Vasanti Yasmin Chatraha Itimat. The place where students live to study the Shastra is called a mat. So you see, when Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur was in this world, he established the Navadvip Dham Pracharini Sabha. It was called the Navadvip Dham Pracharini Sabha. And when he left this world, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, that time his name was Sri Bhasha Banabi Devi Daita Das, Brahmachari, he was the main person along with his brother Lalit Prasad also. All the members of the Pracharini Sabha, they were householders, so they were preaching somewhat, but they also had to use their time in maintaining their families and so on. So it was going on. But suddenly, surprisingly, took everyone by surprise. This Sri Bhasha Banabi Devi Daita Das one day appeared as Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur in saffron cloth and with a danda, and established a mutt. No one had done it before. It was a very great surprise. But what actually happened? What really happened? When he was doing his namrat, chanting 192 rounds every day. At that time, he was thinking, my Chiksha Guru, Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, not father. He never used to say my father. He used to say, to call Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur father is a bada, is an obstacle in spiritual life. His brother Lalit Prasad Thakur used to call him father. He said, but for him, no, this is an obstacle. Because he is the eternal associate of Sri Satchinandan Gaur Hari. And it was by his prayers that caused the, from Goloka Vrindavan, from the Leela of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, so many great personalities to make their appearance in this world. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur used to see his father in that way. But he was remembering that in the summer, just before Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur left, he was alone in the room with him. And he said, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur said to Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, he said, I have tried to preach about the pure bhakti of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And we have established the Navadvip Dham Pracharini Sabha. But in the future, the corrupt seed of Rupa Kaviraj will make its appearance within the Sabha. The corrupted seed of the conception of Rupa Kaviraj. So it was a few hundred years before, at the time of Srila Vishnachari Thakur, there was a devotee who had was very intellectual, very powerful, very learned, but he had made some offenses, and because of this he had deviated. And he was teaching a type of bhakti where you have to imagine your in your mind your spiritual identity. This is the problem. So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur said to him, the corrupted seed of the conception of Rupa Kaviraj will enter into the Sabha. Then our Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, he said, I give you my word that when this happens, that I will dedicate my whole life to eradicate it completely. So what happened shortly after the disappearance of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur? Then this idea that you can imagine your swaroop. And by imagining your swaroop, somehow or other, one day it will become real. This idea crept in. So Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, he left that sangha at once. And he took sannyas from a picture of Srila Gokishodas Babaji Maharaj. And he began to establish Gaudiya Math. Now, there's some controversy over his acceptance of sannyas. Because one may say, well, no one gave him sannyas, he took from a picture. But for a Paramahamsa, like Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then when he looks at the picture of Gokishodas Babaji Maharaj, his guru speaks to him. He can receive mantra from a picture. Even no picture, he sees his guru coming to him. So, no problem. And then others can say, well, he's not following the six Goswamis, because the six Goswamis did not accept sannyas from anyone. And then you can say, no, well, then he's exactly following the six Goswamis. Why? Because Sanatan Goswami, he did not receive the vesh, the renounced vesh from anyone. He just took some second-hand cloth from Tapan Mishra, a dhoti of Tapan Mishra, one householder in Kashi, and he tore it up and made dorkoping, bahivasan, and uttariya, and put it on. So which one is it? Is he, what you want to say? He's not following the six Goswamis, or he's following the six Goswamis? So we can say both. Really, he's a Paramahamsa and following the six Goswamis, but outwardly, he took the form of a sannyasi and established a mart out of compassion for everyone. Because we saw that the Gaudiya Vaishnavism was not spreading nicely throughout society. But in South India, there you can see the mats of Madhvacharya, Ramanujacharya. They have a mat system where young persons can give their full time, 24 hours a day in service, without being entangled in any doing any business or worldly activities. So by this they can preach more and more and serve more and more. So that system, that mat system was already there since ancient times. It wasn't anything new. Only Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, because he's avadut, and because the two missions of the avadut are Prashanda Dalan, are Prema Pracharan, to smash heretical conceptions and distribute prema. So then he took this route and he established Gaudiya Math. What is Gaudiya Math? Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur used to say, the servants of Vishnu are Vaishnavas, the servants of Krishna are Karshnas, and the servants of Radharani are Gaudiya. One name of Radhika is Gauri, and Gauri means sweet. So because she's the only one, Amarama Duryam Rita Ashwade Sakali, she's the only one who tastes Krishna's sweetness fully. And naturally, not refined sugar has been through the chemical process, and that's not so tasty. But swabhavik, very delicious natural sugar is called Gauri. So the natural sugar before it's refined. So similarly, the prema of the gopis of Vrindavan is swabhavik, Rudra Bhava, natural prema. Eta param tanubito bhuvi gopavado govinda eva nikalatmani Rudra Bhava, natural prema. It's not constrained by any social boundaries at all. And therefore it's spontaneous by its nature. It's increasing and increasing beyond all boundaries. So in this way, Srila Barshabarbi Devi Daita Das became Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur and established Gaudiya Math here at the Mool Math where we were this morning. His Samadhi is there also. So, what is the main teaching of Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur? Please, I beg, hear very, very carefully and very, very, very attentively. See, Krishna, Vrindavan, the Leela of Krishna are all aprakrita, supernatural, transcendental. They are nikila praman parichaja agochara. That means Krishna, his name, form, qualities, pastimes. They are not, it is not possible to discover them. They are not accessible by any means of investigation. There is only one way by which they are known. What is that? Shabda Brahma. By the transmission of the absolute truth makes its appearance on the lips of a realized Vaishnava. And when a person is completely surrendered, being niswart, niskapat, having no selfishness and no duplicity, and with all their senses serving their spiritual master, when they give the submissive reception to the Shabda Brahma, then see Krishna makes his appearance before the cognition of that disciple, and Krishna cannot be known in any other way. Srila Jiva Goswami Pad gives an example. You know, it is called the Dasamastvamasi. Dasamastvamasi. There were 10 persons and they were crossing a river in a boat. So they crossed the river and they got out on the other side. Then the leader of the group told someone, oh, you should check that we all made it to the other side of the river. How many people? There are 10 people. So then that person, okay. So then he was counting everyone. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Couldn't find the 10th person. So he counted again. Yes, some of the others, they counted as well. They couldn't find the 10th person. So they reported to the leader of the group that one of us is missing. So then there was a bystander there and he saw the scene. And he went up to that person who was told to count. And he says, Dasamastvamasi, you are the 10th person. And when he said, you are the 10th person, at once that person, he realized, it's me. It wasn't a logical thing. It wasn't a vikalpa imagination or anything. Just the sound, you are the 10th person. And he just had this realization. At once, it was called a jatiti pratita. Immediate revelation, just from the sound. So in the same way, when the chitta is vishuddha, purified, completely purified, when we hear the words of Sri Guru, then there is the spurti. That is the manifestation of the reality in heart. And this is the message of Srimad Bhagavatam, from the beginning to the end of Srimad Bhagavatam, again and again and again. You can see, when Maitreya Rishi is giving instructions to Vidura, he tells the history of Kardama Muni. And Kardama Muni was doing his bhajan, and then he's chanting his mantra, and the Supreme Lord appeared before him. It was Satyayuga. So in Satyayuga, the incarnation of the Supreme Lord, his name is Shukla. Shukla uraktastha pita idanim krishtitam gataha. In Satyayuga, the incarnation of the Lord, his name Shukla, means white, and his name Shukla means white, and he is also called the Shukla avatar. So Shukla appeared before him. And Maitreya Rishi, he's saying to Vidura that Shabda Brahma Dadat Vapu, Shabda Brahma Dadat Vapu, the Shabda Brahma took a form before him, and that was Shabda. So the Shabda Brahma, the transcendental sound, manifests its form before us. Then later in Srimad Bhagavatam, in the sixth canto, you see Chituketu Maharaj, he was doing bhajan, and he had the darshan of Sankarshan Anantadev. And Anantadev told him, Shabda Brahma, Param Brahma, Mamube, the Shashwati Tanu. Shabda Brahma, Para Brahma. Mamube, Shashwati Tanu. Tanu means body. Shashwati means eternal. He's saying, I have two bodies. I have two eternal forms. One is Para Brahma, my form or the deity, and the other is Shabda Brahma. When the Vishnu Dutas, they stop the Yama Dutas from taking away Ajamil, then the Vishnu Dutas say, please, tell us why you're taking this person away, he's pure. And then they said, you should explain. So then the Vishnu Dutas, they began to explain. They said, Vedo Narayana Sakshat. The Vedas are directly Lord Narayana. In the beginning of Srimad Bhagavatam, there Vyasa in his Mangalacharanam, he said, Kimva para Ishvara sadyo ridhyavarudhateyattakitibhisusurusabhitstatsana. What's the use of any other scripture? As soon as you want to hear the Srimad Bhagavatam with eagerness, when the pure devotee speaks it, then Krishna is captured at once in the heart. When Narad met Vyasa also in the first canto, there he said, Iti murtyabhidani na mantra murtim amurtikam yajate yajya purusham sa samyak dashana sa samyak dashana puman. It means that Iti murtyabhidani na, the form, the murti of Krishna, mantra murti amurtikam. Although the Supreme Lord has no gross physical form of this world, He has a mantra murti. So throughout Srimad Bhagavatam, again and again, in every canto, this point is made that the transcendental reality is inaccessible through any process of a mental speculation, any process of empirical investigation. It only comes by hearing. Now, Pashanda Jalan, one of the functions of the Avadut, of the great personality, is to crush the heretics. So there are so many heretics, especially here in Bengal, many Apa Sampradayas came about. Ao Baal Karta Bhaja, Daravesha Sai, Sahaja Sakhi Beti, Smarta Jat Gosai, Nera Neri Chura Dari, Goranga Nagari, Tota Kohi, E Tera Sangi Nahikari. 13 Apa Sampradayas. And all these apasampradayas, all these misconceptions of what is the teaching of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they all come from one thing. That is that either the guru is not qualified, or the qualified guru, when he spoke, then the disciple was listening, but because he was not Sharanagat, he was not surrendered. So there was a maika vyavadhan. That means an illusory obstacle. Maya made an interference in his reception of the Shabda Brahma. So when Maya makes interference in the reception of the Shabda Brahma, then instead of attaining the Tattva Gyan, transcendental knowledge, then you get Parichchinna Gyan. That means only fragments of information. You get Sankirna Gyan, when your understanding is mixed up with mental speculation. You get Vikrita Gyan, a distorted understanding. Or you get Vivarta Grasta Gyan. That means knowledge, but you yourself, you are under the grip of, you have a theoretical knowledge, but you are under the grip of illusion yourself. So you are unable to comprehend it. So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur said, what is the meaning of bhajan? Bhajan means when we chant the holy name, then the form of Krishna begins to manifest. And when the form of Krishna is manifested clearly in the heart, then his qualities, then his associates, and then one can follow his associates, one's own spiritual form, seva, and finally lila. This is the crumb of realization. So, if one goes through each stage, taking shelter of the spurti which is coming, the vision which is coming, by the gradual revelation of the holy name, then that is called bhajan. And if you try to reach beyond your own level of realization, to artificially go to the next stage, then you are guilty of pautalikata. Pautalika. Putalika means a doll. Just like if you go to a shop, you see the clothes are there, But they will not pay anyone to stand in the window all day wearing the clothes, so they have a doll. They have a mannequin, and the clothes are on that mannequin. So this is a putalika, a doll. So it is not a real person. So similarly, when a person is chanting the holy names, and they're taking shelter of the, that is called the Swayam Prakash Shakti of Shabda Brahma. When they're taking shelter of the self-manifesting potency of transcendental sound, then that is real bhajan. Swayam means self, Prakash means manifesting, Shakti means power. So there is the Swayam Prakash Shakti of Shabda Brahma. So when a person is hearing, chanting and remembering, following the Swayam Prakash Shakti of Shabda Brahma, then this is actual bhajan. And when they try to step beyond that by the force of their material mind, now they're doing pautalikata. That is the imitation, the faking, fake bhajan. And so those who are doing fake bhajan, the Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur has coined them with the phrase Prakrita Sahaja. Because the experience of devotion is Prakrita. It is of the material energy, like this. So, therefore, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur used to say, if at all you want to have auspiciousness in your life, then you must only hear from a transcendental source. And by hearing from a transcendental source, one will be oriented and gradually have the spurti of the subject matter and then enter deeply into realization of that. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur wrote an article called Thakur Bhakti Vinod. And in that article he said, there are so many persons who have memorized all the books of Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, but they cannot understand them. Just like we see today, there's so much confusion. Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur said, the Swarup is in the Jiva. And someone is saying, Jiva Goswami says there's no Swarup in the Jiva. And this argument has been going on all over the world, everywhere, between devotees, right? All over the place. Why? To understand the message of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Jiva Goswami, you cannot understand it just by reading their books. So Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur said, there are many persons who have memorized the words of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, but they cannot understand it because they have not submitted themselves to the actual process of hearing the Absolute Truth as it is manifest on the lips of a pure Vaishnava. That is the way to understand. And if one tries to circumvent this process, then all these different apasampradayas come about, and Prabhupada Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur has done this activity. It is not a worldly thing. It is the madness of love of the avadut. Pashandala dalana a prema pracharan dui karya avaduta karna brahman. The avadut is a person who wanders here and there, crushing the heresies and giving prema, both. But what happens? Persons who have duplicity in their mind, who have not surrendered and don't have experience to absolute truth, then they call such persons, they say they are sectarian, that they are bigots, they are not very liberal like me. But their so-called liberalism is only excuse for their duplicity. So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, he waged war against this, and also he was distributing prema. And sometimes when we hear his teachings, it's very shocking. It's very shocking. So, but that shock that one is feeling, that is due to material attachments. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, he used to say, a sadhu is not someone who flatters us. If someone, that person who is flattering you, he is your enemy. The sadhu is like a person at a sacrifice, a goat sacrifice, and standing with upraised chopper. And when you come to a sadhu, then all your material desires and attachments and misconceptions are like so many goats standing in a line, and the sadhu is giving a class and taking them one by one and sacrificing. This is it. Santa evasya chidyanti mano vyasa. And he said in the 11th canto that Santa evasya chidyanti, the association of a sadhu is to cut all of our material attachments, desires and misconceptions. So when we're attached to them, that's somewhat painful, but this is the process. A sincere person will go through that process. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, don't be scared of him. He was very, very gentle. Very, very loving. One time, there was a devotee in the Gaudiya Math. and he did something wrong. He made some mistake. And the other devotees, they were harassing him and criticizing him and shaming him. And he became so embarrassed that he left the mat and disappeared. So, Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Sothakur had sent him far away to establish a preaching center. And so he was there for some time, something happened, and he left. After some time, that temple, they were ready to establish deities there, and they called, "Oh, Srila Prabhupada, please come and do the Pran Pratishtha, establish the deities in the temple." So Prabhupada Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sothakur came there, said, "Is everything ready?" Said, "Yes, the deities are here, we have all the paraphernalia, everything's ready for the fire sacrifice." Then Srila Prabhupada said, "Oh, where is that devotee?" And they said, "Oh, well, he did something wrong and he became embarrassed." And everyone criticized him and he went away. Srila Prabhupada said, "I'm not going to install the deities until he comes back. Go and find him." So then they went, they were looking here and there. And they came and he was working in a wristwatch repair shop. Wouldn't that be, then it would be like this in those days. So he was in a shop, he was repairing watches. So he was there working away. One brahmachari came there to see him and he was surprised. He said, "Srila Prabhupada has come. And now the preaching center has now become the temple and it is ready for the time to install the deities." But he said, "You will not install the deities until you come back." And he's waiting for him. So that devotee was crying. Janakada Dikavatsala Snigdaparam. Srila Bhaktirakshak Shida Maharaj, we sing every morning, Janakada Dikavatsala Snigdaparam. He has more love than your own mother and father, more love than millions and millions of mothers and fathers. That devotee was weeping and he came back to the mat there. Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Sothakur said, "I am not coming this world to make stone buildings. I have come here to collect the souls for the service of Gauranga Mahaprabhu and Radha Krishna." Once there was some bad weather and many of the crops of the farmers in Bengal failed and people were short of food. So in the Gaudiya Mathas they were growing, they had a vegetable garden to make offerings to Thakurji. So one day the devotees, they found one man, he had climbed over the fence and he was in the Thakurji's garden and he was stealing vegetables. And the brahmacharis caught him. "Ha! Now we caught you. We're going to bring you to our leader." So they got him and they brought him in front of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sothakur, threw him down in front of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sothakur. "Here's the thief stealing Thakurji's vegetables." Srila Prabhupada said, "What are you doing?" He said, "My family are hungry. Now the food is so scarce." Prabhupada said, "Let him take whatever he wants and tell the other village they can all come and take whatever they want." He was very kind. They will all remember this, then they will come and listen to Harikatha. Once there was a king and Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Sothakur invited him, "Please come and hear Harikatha." So when the day was there, the devotees, they made an asana for Srila Prabhupada and Srila Prabhupada told his brahmacharis, "Make one asana next to me," the king can sit next to me, "and there you should keep one hookah with a ganja in it." No? A water pipe. Water pipe. And put ganja in it. So then one of the devotees was very upset. "There are four regulative principles and this is breaking the regulative principles. In the age of Kali, then Kali Maharaj lives in that place where anyone breaks the four regulative principles." So he became upset and his faith was shaken in Srila Prabhupada. Guru Nishtha, faith in Guru is the backbone of bhakti. When you have unflinching faith in your spiritual master, then you can progress. But if your backbone, if your spine has a slight injury, what happens? You're paralyzed. You cannot even take one step, a tiny injury. So in the same way, if a disciple has the slightest doubt in his spiritual master, then everything dry. No taste in the holy name, no enthusiasm for bhakti, no energy, no the happiness in devotional life, no appreciation of Vaishnavas, everything. They'll gradually lose everything. So, but what happened? That king came there and he sat next to Bhakti Saraswati Thakur and he was smoking every 5 minutes. But he was listening. And by listening to the powerful Harikatha of Srila Bhakti Saraswati Thakur, he became purified and gradually he began to chant the holy name, and after a short time, Parandrishtva Nivatate. When a person experienced the higher happiness of Krishna consciousness, then they leave the lower things. So he was very, very kind, very merciful. He understood what each person needed and he gave them that very mercifully, gave them what they needed to progress. Sometimes he was extraordinarily strict. Once he had one sannyasi disciple and he sent him to a place in north of India for preaching. So while that devotee was there preaching, he was a sannyasi, he thought, I have never been to Bhadrak Ashram. So he thought, it's nearby, I'll go and do some preaching in Bhadrak Ashram. I'll go and have darshan of Badrinath. So he went to there to have the darshan of Badrinath, and then he came back. So Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Sutrako heard from some devotees, oh, that sannyasi, you sent him here, but he went to Badrinath. So then when that sannyasi came, then Srila Prabhupada took his danda, took his saffron cloth, everything, gave him white cloth and changed his name from Kidandi Swami, whatever it was, your name is Badrinath Das Adhikari. For this, you think it's a small deviation, but he was very strict with his devotees. And now, so he was staying in the mat and he was cooking in the kitchen and washing pots and chopping firewood like this. And he became very, very humble. Tanada peacefully chaina. More humble than a blade of grass. After a few years, the devotees came to Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur and said, oh, Badrinath Das Adhikari, he's so humble, so surrendered completely. Yeah, be kind to him. Then Prabhupada gave his danda back again, blessed him, and he began to preach. So in this way, because Mahaprabhu was said, Ki rupa laila naam prema upajaye, thara lakshan slok suno swarup ramanay, hey Roy Ramananda, hey Swarup Damada, listen to me. The way in which one should chant the holy name, by which one can attain Krishna prema. What is that? Tanada peace uni chaina, tarora peace ishnana, so rather than feed the prestige of that disciple, he gave him mercy and made him Trinada Pisa more humble than blade of grass, so that he could experience the transcendental prayer. One time, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sutaku was invited by his disciple to stay in one room. It was on the top floor of the house, and he brought him into the room. And the windows, he said, oh, the view is very nice and there's a very good breeze here. And then the devotee went outside. Then when he came back in again, Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur shut all the shutters on the windows, and he was chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Yeah? Why? Because his senses are not going outside. I want to see a lovely view and to breathe the fresh air and all this. His senses were not going into the outer world at all. He wanted to show everyone, try to become antarmukh, facing internal, cultivate one's internal spiritual life. One time, a devotee came to him and asked him a question about the Srila Raghunath Das Goswami. So then Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, he began to say a verse of Sri Vila Kusamanjali, Tvam Rupa Manjari Sakhi Patita Purvesmin, this verse, and as he said, said the verse, he began to tremble and he fell off his chair to the ground and he was lying unconscious on the ground. After some time, slowly he came back into external consciousness and he said, oh, Krishna has chastised me because I was about to reveal something very confidential in front of a person who did not have the adhikar, did not have the qualification. So Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Swatako himself was relishing the highest nectar of the Manjari Bhav Seva, following Rupa Manjari and Rati Manjari. So intensely that even he cannot utter one verse of Vilap Kosamanjali without falling unconscious. So he remember, he's avadut, we say. And he has come to crush the heretics and at the same time distribute Krishna prema. So what he used to do? He used to tell very beautiful katha full of rasa. But it was disguised as Tattva Siddhanta. You can see this. This is the niyam of Rasik Vaishnavas. In Srimad Bhagavatam, in Rasalila, Shukadeva Goswami is describing the Rasalila. And he will say, and then Krishna laughed and embraced the gopis. Then they began to dance and they entered into the kunj. And then he'll say, he'll say, Krishna is Parameshwara, Atmaram. And at once he'll go from the rasa of the lila and he'll start speaking all siddhantas. And then, why? Because now the very confidential Nikunja rasa, Nikunja lila of Krishna and gopis is going on. And now he's just seeing that in his trance, outwardly tells Tattva Siddhanta. And then when that's over and it's the next part of the lila, then he comes back to the lila. You see, it happens several times in the Rasa Panchadhyay. So this is the niyam of the Rasik Vaishnavas. So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Swatako was also like that. He used to speak about the glories of Radhika and then he would come very much in the Tattva Siddhanta because he was experiencing that confidential seva. And those who are listening to the Shabda Brahma can catch and experience that those internal services also. But those who are not surrendered with, oh, what is he doing? Only talking about the Vaishnava Pratishtha Shukarera Vishta. He wrote this song, you know, Dostamantu Mikishara Vaishnava. We were just singing this with all the Vaishnavas at his Samadhi this morning. Oh, you wicked mind! What kind of Vaishnava are you? You are very eager to get name and fame and recognition, adoration and respect from others. But you should know that this Pratishtha, this desire for recognition, honor and worship from others is like the stool of a hog. You should make a hard endeavor. Don't put your face in this hog stool. So he's writing poetry like this. But this is the Pasandera Dhalan. But at the same time, those who are hearing him, he's mixing with the very beautiful glorification of Radha and Krishna, Rupa and Raghunath, Gauranga Mahaprabhu. And those who are giving the submissive oral reception to the Shabda Brahma, then internally their realizations become awakened. So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Swatakura, he established Gaudiya Math in the Mool Math there. In the morning time he would come out and go for a walk along the bank of the Ganga with his disciples. There was one old man at that time used to come up to him and criticize him. You are bogus! You are cheating everyone! And he would shout and swear and criticize Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Swatakura in front of his disciples. And the disciples, of course, they wanted to. Yeah. Won't say what they wanted to do. So, but Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Swatakura used to so after some time he was walking there and for many days he did not see that old person. And Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Swatakura, he asked, where is that old person who used to come here? And they said, Prabhupada, he passed away. Then Srila Prabhupada, tears came in his eyes. He said, he was my best friend. He was my best friend. Think about it. When someone criticizes you, if someone will insinuate indirectly that you are not perfect, then how do we feel? Where's my atom? You want to retaliate to the nuclear war. And this is the nature of a hunger. Ego. But Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Swatakura was teaching us, no, those who criticize us, they're our good friends. They're cleaning our heart. When someone is criticized, if they tolerate it very humbly, then that anatta will go away. And if someone is very quick to defend themselves, then their anattas will just grow and grow. So Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Swatakura, at the end of his life, of his manifest pastimes in this world, he was staying in Chatak Parvat, in Jagannath Puri. And he was praying, Nija Nikatani Vasam Dehi Govardhanatvam. Oh, Giriraj, please give me a place by your side. And he instructed his disciples. He said, I want each and every one of you to be ready to give thousands of gallons of your own blood just to nourish the soul of one jiva in this world. This is how intensely he wanted his disciples to engage in prachar. If you can help one person by shedding thousands of gallons of your blood, then it's worth it. He used to say that to to turn one jiva away from Maya and inspire them to come towards Krishna is a more valuable welfare work than opening thousands of schools and hospitals. So he said, all of you, you should sacrifice this body in the seven flames of the fire of the Sankirtan Yajna. You know when you do a fire yajna? Swaha. So there's a fire yajna, and that is the Sankirtan Yajna. It has seven flames. Chaito darpanam marjanam bhava mahada varni nirvapanam swayakayeva chandika vitaranam vidyavadu jivanam anandam budivadanam pratapadam punamritasvarnam saravatmasnapanam param vijayate isi Krishna Sankirtan. These are the seven flames. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sutakwa said, you offer yourself swaha, fully, body, mind and words, into the fire of the Sankirtan Yajna. Doing kirtan everywhere and preaching the glories of the holy name. And if you will do this, he said, then you will discover at the end of your life that you have attained the param purushartha, prema purushartha, the supreme goal of life, transcendental, unconditional, loving service of Sisi Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Gaur Gadada, and Sisi Radha Krishna in the spiritual world. He said, I have not come into this world to be a construction worker. We are carrying the shoes of Rupa Goswami only on our head. And our prayer is Adada Nastinam Danta Idam Yache Puna Puna Srimad Rupa Padambojo Dudisham Jamma Jamani. Taking straw between my teeth and rolling on the ground, I'm begging again and again. Lifetime after lifetime, may I simply become a speck of dust on the lotus feet of Srila Rupa Goswami. So then Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sutakur, he told the devotees to sing Sri Rupa Manjari Pada. So at that time, the very best singer was our Param Pujpad Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Maharaj. So he began to sing. But Srila Bhakti Sanstakur stopped him and told Srila Bhakti Rakeshida Maharaj, you sing. Because he was a more senior and immersed in that conception. So he was not concerned with all rag and tal and beautiful singing voice. All these are nice, they're decorations on the kirtan. But the Shabda Brahma, again we come to the point, main point of his teaching, the Shabda Brahma, the purity of the vibration of the transcendental sound, is the essence by which all realization and perfection comes. So on the, in the, just recently it was a disappearance day, today is his appearance day, today is also the disappearance day of Srila Gaura Govinda Maharaj. Srila Gaura Govinda Maharaj was born in the village of Jagat Singhpur in Orissa in a Gaudiya Vaishnav family. So from the moment he was born, he was engaged in kirtan. All of his uncles, his father's brothers and others, they had a kirtan group that would go from village to village. From the age of 5 or 6, he used to give class on Chaitanya Charitamrita. When he was 5 years old, he had a friend, now we know him as the Pujapad Professor Fakir Mohan Prabhu. So when they were about 5 years old, they looked on a map and they saw, oh, Orissa is here and the Himalayas are there. Oh, the Himalayas are only 4 inches away. So we should go to the Himalayas and do bhajan there like yogis. So the 2 5-year-old boys, they set off from their village. And they set out and they were wandering. So after they went through a few villages, they got hungry and they saw a sweet shop. So they went in the sweet shop to buy some sweets. And while they were sitting there, then the owner of the shop recognized them and sent someone to bring them. The father came and brought them back. So they had very close, loving relationship from childhood. When Fakir Mohan was about 9, he ran away from home and he joined the Bagbazar Gaudiya Math. But Srila Gaura Govinda Maharaj completed his education. When he was very young, he was married. He was about 16 when he was married and he met his wife. He saw his wife for the first time during the yajna of the wedding day. It's completely traditional family. So he was married, he had about 7 children and he was a school teacher. But the problem was, he used to get sometimes in trouble in the school because though he was supposed to teach English and mathematics, he was just teaching about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teachings. All the students loved it. But the curriculum wasn't going on. So, after some time, when he was about 45 years old, then he decided to, he had been serving his deity of Gopal in the village of Gadagiri his whole life. But when he was about 45 years old, he was inspired by Gopal to leave home. And he was wandering all over India. He went to the Himalayas. And finally he came to Vrindavan. And there he met Srila Prabhupada. And when he came into Srila Prabhupada's room and Srila Prabhupada saw him for the first time in their first meeting, he said, "I'll give you sannyas." He said, "Have you taken sannyas?" "No, I'll give you," because he was wearing a saffron cloth and he had a hair in jata, actually, in dreadlocks. And so, "Have you taken?" "No, I'll give you sannyas." And on the inspiration of Srila Prabhupada, he went to, Srila Prabhupada sent him to Bhubaneswar in the middle of a jungle, and he made a mud hut in the jungle there, and he was doing bhajan. And one of his students that he used to teach when he was a student, when he was a teacher, he had a bicycle, and he used to sit on the rack of the Indian bicycle, and his student used to cycle around and take him from place to place preaching. Gradually his preaching was very successful, and he made a huge temple and a guest house, but he always lived in the same hut with the straw roof. He himself never lived in the big temple or the guest house. He lived in the same hut with the straw roof that he built with his own hands the 25 years before. So I was very fortunate, I had a good fortune in my life to travel with him all over England, all over France and Italy, Portugal, Spain, everywhere, and also come and live with him. Actually, I was traveling all over England with him. I had a Sankirtan van, and I took all the Sankirtan devotees from the temple in London, Soho Street, all of them. I didn't tell the president or anything. I just said, "Listen, just come with me." Why? Because sadhu sanga sarva shastra koi. Lava mantra sadhu sanga sarva shastra. Sadhu sanga is the most important ingredient in our spiritual life. Krishna bhakta janma mool hoi sadhu sanga. Prema bhakti janma tena puna mukha anga. Chetanmapu tot sanatan goswami pad. That the root cause of the appearance of bhakti is sadhu sanga. And even when your bhakti develops up to praying, still the most important thing in your life is sadhu sanga. So don't think there's a point where I don't need sadhu sanga anymore. So susurya bhajana vigyam ananya anya nindari shundaridam ipsita sanga labdhya. So that means that association of pure Vaishnavas is ipsita, desirable. It's always, sometimes I've had enough sadhu sangha. Lava mantra, I had half a second. So I've had enough. No, sadhu, you may have had enough to attain your perfection. Yet still, it's always desirable. Once I was sitting in Srila Gurudev's room alone with him, and he was chanting. And he was very in a very grave mood. And he looked up at me and he said, "Brain, I want sadhu sangha." I was thinking, I'm there getting sadhu sangha. He said, I want sadhu sangha. He was feeling separation from Srila Bhakti Prakaran Keshav Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Trivikram Maharaj, Srila Vaman Maharaj. So, sadhu sangha is the most important thing. So I just got all the devotees, put them in a van, and we traveled all over England and Wales. With the classes, hearing the classes of Srila Gobinda Maharaj. No one knew where we were. So at that time, the temple president was freaking out because they have to collect money every day to pay for the bills, and this is, the temple is in debt. Rabbi London Nishwari is in debt. Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And Bhagavan, who is completing six opulences, is in debt. So then they finally tracked me down. They found we're in Wales. And they said, "Hey, you have to come back at once." I said, "We're on the tour, we're having sadhu sangha, hearing Hare Katha. We'll come back when the tour is over." Just said, but Krishna can manage his own debts. Krishna can take care of it. I said, "The only reason we are distributing the books is to make the Sukriti to get the sadhu sangha. So when the sadhu sangha comes, if we say no to go to distribute the books then." What is this? This is quite wrong. So anyway, by the time I arrived back in, when I arrived back in London, then there was a message of the president wanted to speak to you. He said, "You have to, the GBC have contacted me and said you're a danger to the Sankirtan mission, you have to leave." No. So brahmachari with no money, out. So directly from the temple, I went to Srila Gauravinda Maharaj. He was in one house, he was just about to go to the airport to fly. And I gave my obeisances at his feet. And I said, "Oh, do you know what happened to me?" He said, he raised his hand, he said, "This is the direct mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Now you come and live with me in Bhubaneswar." So I was very grateful to all those who threw me out, because then I moved to India to stay with Srila Gaur Govinda Maharaj. So Maharaj was saying earlier that Srila Gaur Govinda Maharaj, he had a siddhi that is called Swachanda Mrityu. There are 8 prominent siddhis, and then there are 10 secondary siddhis. So there are 18 siddhis. No, one of them is called Swachanda Mrityu. The ability to leave this world at your own choice, at your own discretion. So when I was there in Bhubaneswar, there was, I was making one book for Srila Gaur Govinda Maharaj. He said, make books from my lectures. So we were making, perhaps you heard of a book called The Embankment of Separation. So it was ready, all his lectures were ready, but I had written some introduction to the book and epilogue for that book. So I wanted to, what I had written, I wanted it to be, wanted him to check it, that it's okay to print. So I came to his room and he said, you come back later. So then I was waiting, and it was quite late at night, 9:30 at night. Then he called me back to his mud hut. And I came inside. I had left the paper with him and he'd read it. And then I came back for his opinion. So later night I came in and gave pranam. I said, Maharaj, is it paper? He said, yes, it's good, you can print it. Gave it back. And then he just began to speak spontaneously with no, I didn't ask any question. He said, Srila Bhakti Sansar Thakura said that this world is no fit place for a gentleman. And that is why he left prematurely. And I am also thinking that I will leave. They are trying to take advantage of my simplicity. Some problem was going on with some of his godbrothers. And then he said, so I will also leave. He said, but I cannot be independent. I cannot be independent. I will have to ask Gopal. So then the next day we traveled from Bhubaneswar to Gadagiri, to his childhood deity of Gopal. And he came there and he was praying in front of Gopal. And then he didn't say anything. He told a story. And it was a story that Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur would tell. It was a story about some monkeys. And the monkeys were living in the palace of a king. They were like pets to one prince. And they were very happy there. They had everything they needed. Then one day one old monkey, he said, we have to leave this place. The young monkey said, no, we're not leaving. It's great here, we're living in the palace, we're like kings. The old monkey said, no, we have to leave. I said, why do we have to leave? He said, because one day one of the sheep will go into the kitchen and the cook will take it to drive him out, will take a log from the fire and hit the sheep to drive him out. But then the sheep will catch on fire and he'll run and he'll go into the stable. And then the stable will be on fire and the horses will be burned. And the cure for the burns is monkey fat. So the king, thinking that his horses are more valuable than the monkeys, will have us all killed and to cure his horses. Then the young monkeys are like, oh, this old monkey has gone senile, he's crazy. We're not listening to him. So then they didn't listen to him, so then the old monkey, he left. After a few days, then the sheep went in the kitchen and the servant beat him and he caught on fire and then he burned down the stable and the horses were burnt and then all the monkeys were killed and then that was used to heal him. And they were all destroyed. He told this story and he said the moral of the story is this, that young persons who are not have no understanding of spiritual life, they're like the young monkeys. They don't understand what the future holds for them, where they are going. And the old monkey, he has experience, he has realization, but they didn't listen to him. So when we don't listen to our Gurujan, when we don't pay attention deeply and follow the instructions of our superiors, then only disaster is waiting. So at that time, Srila Gaur Govinda Maharaj had been telling, the jiva does not fall from Vaikuntha. But many were not listening, they were making problems. He was telling the spiritual master should have realization, have Krishna praying, realization of Krishna. Then they were all making problems for him. So it seems that this story that he told was the answer to the question. Because he asked Gopal, should I stay or should I go? But he didn't tell us the answer. But he told this story. And from this story, then we could understand actually that he gave the answer. But at the time, we could not understand. We could not believe it. So then after that, he came back to Bhubaneswar, and it was Nityananda Prabhu's appearance day. So perhaps you know Srila Gauranga Vinayamaji used to sit on his Vyasasana, and he used to have his walking stick by. And when he was giving class, he would grab his walking stick and he would whack people on the head. He would ask them a question. Do you know this verse? No? Oh. Hit them with a walking stick. So Srila, my Gurudev, Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, he said that actually he was a Vaishnava Abhiram Thakur. There was an associate, one of the Dwadash Gopals, an associate of Nityananda Prabhu, and he had a whip. And he used to go and whip people, and anyone who was whipped by him would get Krishna praying. So he said that he was absorbed in the avesha of Abhiram Thakur. So it's true, those who got hit by him definitely felt great purification. So on that day, Nityananda Prabhu's day, he was singing so many kirtans. Nitai guna mani ama, nitai guna mani. And he was swinging his walking stick above his head. And he was bouncing up and down right off the Vyasasana. Jai Nitai, Jai Nitai.
He was
in...
his leg was bad.
Yeah.
He would bounce.
He was... You can see. And it was very, very ecstatic. And then just after that, he had to go come here to Mayapur for the meetings, GBC meetings. So he came here. Very miraculous thing happened. One guru was making some plan to kick Srila Gauranga Vinayamaji out of ISKCON. I'm not telling this to criticize, so I'll not take any names. It's not to criticize anyone, only to give some small insight into the position of the transcendental Vaishnavas. So this devotee actually, many years before, how can we find it? There was one devotee who came to Srila Bhakti Rakshak Shridhar Maharaj. And she was living there in ISKCON and she was coming and hearing from him. And she wanted to take initiation from him. But if she did not take initiation over there, then they would kick her out. So he said, Shridhar Maharaj said, just take initiation from someone there. So she said, should I take initiation from this one? He said, no, he'll leave in a couple of years. And then she said, oh, no, what about this one? He said, yes, take initiation from him. It will take him, he will fall down after 20 years. So this was in, let me see. I can't remember the exact, he said he'll fall down after 20 years. So now, this was exactly 20 years later, and that very devotee was making a plan to try to get Srila Gauranga Vinayamaji out from the ISKCON. So then, when he was coming out of the meeting, then that devotee was rebuking him. And he told him, he said, in a few days, I will leave. But in 2 years, you will leave Krishna consciousness, he said to that person. And so then a few years later, that devotee completely went away from, he was very highly ranked person, went away from Krishna consciousness. Srila Gauranga Vinayamaji came to his room and he was sitting there and the wife of someone in their former ashram came to see him along with Chandrika. And they wanted to ask him a question about Krishna's Leela. So Srila Gauranga Vinayamaji was sitting on his bed and they were sitting down. And he began to tell a very beautiful pastime. How Srimati Radhika was in Vrindavan and Krishna was in Dwarka. And Srimati Radharani was burning in the fire of separation. And she said to her Sakis, Akarunya Krishna Yadi Maitavaga Katamadam. Mudama rodi meikuru ramimam utarakritim. Tamalasyas kande vihita bujavala rihiam yata brindaranyam chiram avichala tistati tunu. She said, O Sakhi, If Krishna will not be merciful to me, then you should not cry, because it's not your fault. She said to Vishakha, Vishakha said he was crying. You should not cry, it's not your fault if Krishna doesn't give mercy to me. But I ask you one thing. I want you to smear my whole body with the dust of Jamuna. And then you should write in that dust the name Sham, Sham, Sham all over my body and put a tosi leaf there. Because Krishna and his name are none different. And just now I will leave this world. And you should take my dead body and wrap my arms. You should do my funeral ceremony. How? In this way. Wrap my arms around a tamal tree on the bank of Jamuna so that I can be here forever. So when Radharani was in this condition and she was about to give up her life, the power of Radhika's loving separation was bringing Krishna from Dwarka. And Krishna came from Dwarka riding on a chariot. And when he arrived there, he got down from the chariot. Then the fragrance of the Krishna's, he got down from the chariot and he saw Radhika about to leave her body, about to die in separation. Because Radhika cannot, but it's the Bahar. It's the tenth stage of separation, Mrityu. It's like death. Once a devotee asked Gurudev, how can death be the tenth stage of separation in the spiritual world, no one dies? And Gurudev, he was in a deep bath and he said, it is worse than death. So Radhika was in that condition. And when Sri Krishna jumped down from the chariot and saw her in that condition, he became so overwhelmed that his body melted and his arms came inside, his legs came inside and his eyes became big and it became the form of Jagannath. So then Lalita and Vishakha, they said to Radhika, oh, Krishna is here. So then when she heard that, then Radhika came out from her pain of separation and she looked and saw Krishna. And then the eyes of Radhika looked in the eyes of Krishna and the eyes of Krishna looked into the eyes of Radhika for the first time after long separation. And when Srila Gaugavinda Maharaj said, and then the two eyes of Radha Krishna met, then he began to choke in ecstasy and he was trembling. And he said, I cannot speak. So this is called Samriddhiman Sambhog. The very intense, fully enriched, ecstatic meeting of Radha and Krishna. Because Navi Navi Pralambena Sambhoga Pushtimasbute. The joy of meeting is not nourished to its highest point without separation. So after long separation, at long distance, then this meeting, no words can describe it. So Srila Gaur Govinda Maharaj, being in Manjari Bhav, being in the mood of a maidservant of Radhika, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur said, Sri Krishna virahe Radhika Radasa Amito Sahiti Nari Jugal Milano Sukera Karna Jivete Chariti Pari. I cannot tolerate the condition of Radharani when she's in separation for Krishna. In order to bring the divine couple together for their happiness of meeting, I am ready to give up my life hundreds of times. This is the mood of Kamala Manjari. So Srila Gaur Govinda Maharaj, being absorbed in his swarup of Manjari Bhav and seeing the Samriddhiman Sambhog, that intense meeting of Radha and Krishna, he could not speak any longer. So then he turned to his, there was a picture of Gopal by his bed and he took the picture of Gopal and looked at it and then he held it on his heart and said, Gopal! And then he lay back and he was still, didn't move. So the devotees said, oh, that one should leave, they went out. Only some servants were there and they were massaging him. But after a long time, he still didn't move. So then they called the doctor, and doctor came. He has departed. Just like this. In a state of ecstasy. So one thing Srila Gaur Govinda Maharaj, he used to say very often. He used to say, a sadhu never speaks theoretically. Anyone can say, Venum kwanantam aravinda dalayataksham bahavatamsa. Buddha Sundarangam, Kandapakuti Kamani, Krishna has a complexion like a blue rain cloud and he's playing a flute and decorated with a peacock feather and charming so many cupids. Anyone can say that. But a sadhu never speaks theoretically. That means he's seeing how Krishna is more beautiful than millions of cupids if he's speaking that. When he's speaking, then. If a sadhu is speaking a pastime, then that pastime is going on. So sadhu never speaks theoretically. So every day before class, Srila Gogavinda Maharaj in his Mangalacharanam, he used to give a long Mangalacharanam. And one of the, his Mangalacharanam was a song. Paramananda he madhava padangaluchi makaranda se makaranda panakari anande bolo hari hari. And in this song, it's saying that, oh, chant the holy names and drink the nectar of the lotus feet of Radha Madhav. And in the last line of the verse, it says that, oh, when will that day come when I'll be sinking in the ecstasy of the hearing and chanting the glories of Radha Madhav, and then being absorbed in the ecstasy of their loving pastimes. Moti udara radha dava. Then Krishna will go and my soul will leave and enter into their eternal service. So every day before class he used to sing this song. And he also used to say, a sadhu never speaks theoretically. So just as he said, when will that day come when I'll be hearing and speaking Harikatha and absorbed in ecstasy of the Leela, and then Krishna will call me and I'll go to his Leela. As he said it every day, then he lived it in his life also on this day there in his room in the Mayapur Chandadaya Mandir. Param Puja Pad Srila Gauragavinda Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai. Nitrila Pristam Vishnu Pada Stodra Sada Sisi Mad Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur Jai Guru Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Vyasam Puja Chiti Ma Mahotsava Ki Jai. Ananta Koti Vaishnava Vrinda Ki Jai. Sankata Bhakta Vrinda Ki Jai. Jai Gaur Premanande.